Hey guys, check out the complete video of this patient who showed up with a knife stuck in his hand and what we did to relieve it. This medical video is brought to you by Best Grades. Get the best grades with the least amount of effort. Don't just study harder, study smarter. Have you ever wondered why people who maybe don't study as much as you do get better grades? Well, that's because they study efficiently. They study the right way. With this course, you can learn the techniques that will make you a better person to study and a better exam taker. Like five things that you can do in 5 minutes to get better grades. Check it out in the link below. Do this. Thank you so much.
Ma, I love you.
What happened?
Mr. Step went to catch himself, and the knife has fallen just vertical as he was going down.
Wait, can you see the hand? You see how it slants? And how crazy is that it stands up?
Did I get that right? You just fell right on it.
We were here last night. He got a staple in his hand.
I told him about the fight. Right. And then I got the fight.
I see his hand.
And I take care of a 15-year-old boy who was dehydrated and had to come by the ambulance here last night too. So this is awesome.
All right, here comes the unveiling. I'll be very gentle. Who put this in?
It was his bandage from yesterday.
Oh my goodness! Well, good job.
Recycling. I like it.
Yeah.
I don't know if you
want to
watch that now.
I do.
Okay, dude.
I'm not looking.
I bet you seen it happen.
No, yeah. He was outside.
I
had to go.
Friends. I was at Matthew's.
Yeah. Looking like a little homeless kid, so I do.
That's right. They always look homeless when you do something like
this. So there it is.
I can't open it up again.
Just let it be. If you want to rest it, it'll be better. I do want to know. I know you said just pull it out, but you know what? That's what we're here for. Try to decrease the pain.
Yeah,
it's
okay.
It's in his
hand. He's gonna cry like a little girl.
You think so?
What? You better not tell.
Don't we all cry like little girls? I mean, that's the way you cry.
Hey, I don't know how to take that. I'm a girl.
He didn't cry when he got that staple.
He didn't?
Mm-mm.
I only cried for a minute when it happened.
Yeah.
You
don't
have some like food.
Yeah, you smell like gum. You got any gum?
No, I don't, but I'll get you some.
Mm-hmm.
I borrowed it from somebody at work.
What?
Can't open my fingers.
You
can
do a
radio
block.
Oh, man. Hey, old man.
He didn't see it till I've ever been to it.
That's not her.
He
does walk out like a little girl. Big girl.
Big girls don't
cry.
Can you get me, I know you don't want to miss this. I'm just going to know while you're gone. A laceration on trip.
Yes.
Oh,
I don't think it'll affect my fingers, man.
We won't know until we did it out, kind of thing. I mean, obviously, it hit either stuck in the bone, tendons, or whatever. Once we take it out, we'll see how much you can move. Right now, you don't want to move it. Even if you could move, that knife is holding it in place. So when we take it out, if that finger moves, then it's fine. It probably did make the tendon, ligaments, nerves even. But there's very little we can repair here. Let's say, for argument's sake, when we take it out, that finger no longer moves. It's torn. All we're going to do is clean up really nice, irrigating stuff, close the outside of the skin, and then put on a splint and send you to a hand specialist. There's different kinds. There's the orthopedic doctors who work here, and there's one out of Ackworth that we can send you to.
Okay.
You're doing a fine job, so. All right, I'm going to go underneath and numb the area, okay? Pinch, buddy.
Stop.
You're doing incredible enough.
What?
Are you seriously taking
pictures? Oh, yes, I'm seriously taking a picture. How often does this happen? To you, a lot.
We're getting HD video, so we got all the pictures.
I want to get a copy of that.
You're going to get... I'm going to give you the website address. We're going to load this up. Because I do, What I do is I convert it into a teaching file. I put audio,
I talk about the potential injuries. I talk about what sort of things are we worried about. And then I have an education channel. I do a lot of that.
Then Dad don't get hurt again.
Careful, sharp.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what the black stuff is on my knife. Tar or something. I don't know if I might want to clean it up good. Tar at the tip of my knife.
Okay,
yeah.
I think
that's what
that is.
Mm-hmm.
That's what they did. That's what that is. That's all that is.
Is it not?
Still feel a little bit, but it's fine. You want me to hold one of these on the other side?
Yeah. This is a sneeze, and it's fine. Well, it's way too easy. So what we got now? So like that, it looks like nothing, just a tiny little cut, but obviously it goes deep. I'm gonna see your closer fist. So it does that. Okay, good. So even if the tendon is nicked, it's not tearing all the way through. That's the first thing we need. Now close again. Close. Close it.
Huh?
Like this. There you go. Now don't let me open it. Keep it down. Good. So we can resist. We can resist. The other thing we look for, capillary refill. And do you feel me?
Mm-hmm.
Same in all fingers.
This one's got a little tingle in it.
A little
like
tingle?
No.
That might come back. That might not. Sometimes we can't tell. So let's irrigate this sucker.
Can
we
get stitches in it?
Yeah, we will. We'll get that.
Ew, green stuff.
I wonder if this goes through.
Ah, green stuff. You see that? Mm-hmm. You spread that waffles. Mm-hmm. You spread that waffle out. Mm-hmm. And cut it where it sits. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I tried to get a stinky shirt on. It's the only shirt I could find.
I'm gonna use the syringe.
Mama.
I'm sharp off.
No.
Now, because it is a puncture wound, we don't want to do a really tight closure either. We just want to maybe put one, maybe two stitches in there, just so that if there's any infection in there, that's eventually going to work its way out. It has a way out. At the first signs of infection, if it starts getting really red, pussy, then we need to open the stitches up and let it air out.
Hello?
Matt,
what you doing, girl? Matt, hold on, okay? Put your shoes on and walk out here, man.
Wow, can I get a
closure? So definitely not as bad as we all thought, which is good. Do we have a furrow? Just a furrow will do. We got this. Stanley knife.
Furrow, what would you like?
Little product placement in the video.
Actually, do Vicryl. Vicryl, yeah. Yeah, I'm going to use Vicryl. Vicryl is absorbable, so if it doesn't look infected, you can let it in. and eventually fall off on its own. So we've ruled out arterial injury, has good capillary flow, plus there's no big arteries right there. There's the ulnar, are you getting this? There's the ulnar arch, there's the radial arch here, there's a deep arch and a superficial arch, and he could have got that one, but there's always collateral flow, so we're not too worried about that. The two big nerves, or three big nerves that come through the hand, ulnar, radial, median nerve. And if you nick it all the way out here, yeah, there could be some numbness, tingling. The likelihood is there's always some other nerves that take over that function, but even if it's not, there's so little, it would have to be a microsurgeon to fix those. Generally speaking, we don't fix those.
As long as I can bow my fingers, am I?
Yeah, exactly. It's workable. You're right-handed or left-handed?
Right-handed.
Perfect. So what we'll do is we'll put a stitch or two, we'll put you on a splint, probably so that finger doesn't move a lot and you can rest. We'll put you on antibiotics. You already got your tetanus shot, so we're basically done.
Dissolvable kind?
Mm-hmm. By the way, you did a tremendous job at immobilizing it. You must have watched some EMT shows or something like that.
I've just been hurt enough to know better.
Clean with soap and water, no alcohol, no peroxide. Antibiotic cream a little bit. Put a band-aid or a cover over it. And then wear the splint at least for a week, maybe even more than that, because that tendon is going to take some time to heal and everything. And if you start overworking, you might tear it all away. Right now it's not tore all the way, maybe it's nicked, but we don't know for sure. But since it has function, if we mobilize it, then you'll have a chance to heal and it won't be an issue. Mm-hmm. All right, so that's it, we're all done. Two stitches, this is maybe a 2 centimeter laceration, probably. Did not cry like a little girl, just because he wanted to show off his son. Questions, concerns?
Dude, no,
you're awesome.
Appreciate it.
Nice.
Glad to help.